Where the Congress party now says it has expelled the lawyer who represented extradited Agusta Westland scam middleman Christian Michel in the latest. The Congress has now taken that decision to expel Joseph. Let's tell you why. Lawyer Aljo Joseph headed the legal cell of the youth wing of the Congress party and also represented Christian Michel in that case. The party now says it does not endorse Joseph's actions and has now decided to expel the lawyer. Let's get in further details now from Wion's political editor, Karthike Sharma, joining us. This is a double whammy for the Congress, Karthike. It's also coming at a time when the party is already facing several question marks over the Agusta Westland scam case yet again because of Christian Michel's extradition. Now, what the lawyer had said was that his association with the Congress had nothing to do with his legal representation of Christian Michel. But the Congress definitely does not quite agree and has been caught in that embarrassing situation.
Well, absolutely. I agree with you that it has not only embarrassed the Congress party, it was like a political harakiri. It was like, Congress wanting to run an anti-corruption campaign against Prime Minister Modi. And then you realize that you have one of the people who is actually representing the Christian Michel as a lawyer and then going on air with an agency saying that that has nothing to do with my party. So imagine the scare it has caused in the Congress that not only they have dissociated themselves, but they have expelled Mr. Joseph as a primary member of the Congress party. Generally, this step is not taken. You know, people either dissociate or say that we have expelling this person from the position of authority in the Congress organization. He has been expelled from the primary membership of the Congress party. And it's for the simple reason they realize that there are certain things which are okay in 2010 cannot be okay in 2018. If you would remember that Abhishek Manu Singhvi, celebrated lawyer, also fought a case on which Ramesh Munyappa, who headed the Congress Kerala, fought against it. And the Congress took them, I think, 4 or 5 months to persuade and make Mr. Singhvi come around, and he had to leave the case. But this time around, I think there cannot be any compromise because Agusta Westland case is something which complicates things for Congress. Because, you know, you have acronyms which sounds similar to the names of certain political leaders associated with the Congress. So they had to do this. So I think they had no other option but to cut ties with him. That is why he has been expelled. But what surprises me is that it has taken 4 to 5 hours to do it. And what even surprises me more, Molly, is that the gentleman had the audacity to go on air and saying that this is my private matter and I'm being head of the Youth Congress legal department head, has nothing to do with it. So that is the surprising part, because it tells you about discipline and how disconnected the structures of power within the organization are.
Indeed. So this could not have been coming at a worse time for the Congress. What this also tells us, as Karthike is pointing out, is that no consultations were held between Joseph and the party leaders. The party now saying that he did not even care to inform the Youth Congress leaders about his decision to represent Christian Michel. Remember, this is in reference to the Agusta Westland scam case, which already has the Congress left with multiple questions to answer. And it has been trying to save face on that very case. But now yet another embarrassment coming in for the Congress relating to that case. Definitely a controversy it could have avoided. The lawyer who represented Christian Michel turned out to be a leader of the Youth Congress, had come out to then say that he was representing Christian Michel in his personal capacity and had nothing to do with the Congress, and now has been expelled from the party. We're going to leave it there for the moment. Karthike, thanks very much for that quick roundup of what's happened over the last few minutes. But certainly this case has become a political war of scams. The Agusta Westland case versus the Rafael jet deal, as political attacks over the arrest of the middleman Christian Michel escalate. The ruling BJP has said that the extradition in the UPA era case could spell serious trouble for the Congress's first family. The party also asserted that the development was an unequivocal affirmation of the Narendra Modi government's seriousness when it comes to fighting corruption. Prime Minister Modi also directly hit out at the Congress party over the Agusta Westland scam. The deal for purchase of luxury choppers was signed during the Congress-led UPA government. Prime Minister Modi said that while the scam took place during the Manmohan Singh prime ministership, it was his government that was set to bring the beneficiaries to justice.
कदम उठाया है देश में वीवीआईपी हेलीकॉप्टर और वो चिट्ठी तो मालूम होगी मैडम सोनिया जी की चिट्ठी है वीवीआईपी हेलीकॉप्टर ढूंढते रहे और उसमें से एक राजदार हाथ लग गया हिंदुस्तान के ये नामदारों के यार दोस्तों को वो कटकी देता था उनका ख्याल रखता था भारत सरकार कल दुबई से उसको उठा करके ले आई है अब ये राजदार राज खोलेगा पता नहीं बात कब तक पहुंचेगी कितनी दूर तक पहुंचेगी
Congress President Rahul Gandhi was swift to launch a counter-strike. He targeted Prime Minister Modi by raising the Rafal deal when asked about the Agusta scam.
Congress party has made its position very, very clear on this matter. Earlier in a press conference, the Prime Minister should explain why he gave 30,000 crores on Rafal to Mr. Anil Ambani. Thank you.